Hello and welcome to the show. In this episode, I'm going to start putting together the Raspberry Pi 2 Portable Mark 6. So in this particular version, I'm using acrylic. This particular acrylic is a smoke gray color. Get a piece out there. Looks like a bit purple, but it's a smoke gray. The idea is to have a Raspberry Pi and a banana Pi in the same laptop style device. The banana Pi doing the server end of the project and the Raspberry Pi doing the GUI or the front end. So power regulator for the banana Pi, Wi-Fi dongle for the banana Pi. Raspberry Pi won't have Wi-Fi. It will be connected to the banana Pi via Ethernet. So two Pis working together, not doing a typical load sharing activity or running as a cluster. That doesn't really work in this configuration. But what does work reasonably well is having one do backend functions and server functions and network provision functions and firewall and NFS and file server and all of that sort of stuff, and have the Raspberry Pi do nothing but serve the GUI. So that will be the banana Pi backend. That will be the Raspberry Pi front end, power regulator for the Raspberry Pi. This will be the driver board for the 10-inch LCD IPS display when it finally arrives, and I've been waiting a month now. So that's the reason that this video is starting as late as it is. Hopefully that won't be too far away and we can actually crack on with the build. In the top half will be the screen and the driver board itself. In the bottom half, I'll have the two Pis, and they will be tethered via Ethernet. I'll have a battery bank using this one I've taken out of the Doshin power bank. And I'll also use, within the project, the little display that actually gives us our voltage or our remaining power from the battery bank itself. Power regulator, the spark phone one I've used many times before. And I'll need a HDMI cable to connect the Raspberry Pi to the display. Also be using the RAI keyboard. I don't mind that one, and it fits really nicely within an A4 sized 10-inch laptop. So as I mentioned, we're talking about a 10-inch laptop styled design. Two pieces of the acrylic will form the base and two pieces of acrylic will form the lid, and just join those two together. So the way everything's intended to go together, like I said, battery bank here, spark fun charging up the battery bank, and the little display board here letting us know how much we've got going left in the battery, how much capacity is remaining. A 5 volt power regulator here. This one will provide power to the Raspberry Pi 2 and the driver board and the 10-inch display when they finally get here. And this power regulator will provide power to the banana Pi. And with the banana Pi, I do actually have the ability to, as you'll probably notice there, this one has a SATA port. So I am able to, if there's enough space in the device and I really wanted to, I'm actually able to hook up an external hard drive. So there's nothing stopping this having a terabyte capacity rather than just the standard capacity through the thumb drives and SD cards. So that is the approach for the assembly of this particular device. As you can see on the screen now, I've got a rough mock-up of how everything will go with inside the project. But before I continue, I actually want your input. So if you have an idea on what else could go into this project or what shouldn't go into this project, keep it minimal, or add more functions and features, by all means, let me know before I get the screen and actually start doing this particular build. So leave your comments, suggestions, ideas, etc. in the comments of this particular video, and I'll take a look at those before I go ahead and do the next video and start the rest of this build. So thanks very much for joining me and watching the show. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up, that really helps a lot. Subscribe, of course, leave comments in the comments section of this video, I always look at those. And I hope you'll join me again in a week's time.